Welcome to the online video lecture series of the course Computer Organization and Architecture. In last class, we have talked about virtual memory concept and we have seen how pages are referenced and how the mapping of virtual address with the physical address is done using memory page table. And we have also talked about associative memory mapping scheme. And we have also discussed about page fault. So, whenever page fault occurs, the operating system is called and the page replacement algorithm or the reference page is replaced with some page of the main memory. So, how this replacement algorithm will take place? You can see. When page fault occurs, the memory management software system handles all the software operations for the efficient utilization of memory space. It must decide which page in the main memory ought to be removed to make room for a new page. And the next concept is when a new page is to be transferred from auxiliary memory to main memory. And where this page is to be placed in main memory. So, to design any page replacement algorithm, these three basic concepts has to be understand or to take care of these three basic concepts. We have to take care of these three basic concepts. Which page has to be transferred and when this new page has to be transferred and where this page has to be replaced or placed in main memory. Because virtual memory is a combination of hardware and software both. So, the architecture of hardware and software management we have to understand in case of virtual memory. So, there are few schemes of page replacement designed by the researcher or programmers. The first one is first in, first out. This is the first simplest scheme of page replacement algorithm handled by the operating system. The system software replaces the required page if page fault occurs. So, what we do in this particular scheme? So, let us try to understand. It selects for replacement the page that has been in memory the longest time. So, in this particular scheme, we have to select that page which is available since long time or available with long time. So, each time a page is loaded into memory, next step, its identification number is pushed into a FIFO stack. So, we have to maintain a queue or you can say a FIFO stack where each page has its own identification number will be loaded into that particular queue. So, it is first come first served based or first in first out manner. It works in the manner of first in first out. And in next step, FIFO will be full whenever memory has no empty space, no more empty space. So, obviously, the queue is full or the stack is full, we cannot store next identification number or next reference page. And in next step, what we do in this algorithm, when a new page must be loaded, the page least recently brought in is removed. So, this is very important step, we have to find out the least recently brought in page. So, that has to be replaced if page fault occurs. And in next step of this algorithm, the page to be removed is easily determined because its identification number is at the top location of the stack. Or you can say it was first arrived in the queue and it is located at the top location of the stack. So, that has to be replaced or removed. That has to be removed, sorry. So, there are few advantage and disadvantage of this algorithm. It is very simple algorithm or easy to implement. We can easily design this algorithm. But apart from this, there is one disadvantage. Under certain circumstances, pages are removed and loaded from memory too frequently. So that is the main disadvantage of this particular scheme. Let's do with the help of one example. So here you can see a virtual memory system has an address space 8K. So there are 8K words. A memory space is 4K words. So, in this example, address space is given as 8K words and memory space is given as 4K words, and one page size is given as 1K word, and the block size obviously will be of 1K word. The following page reference changes occur during a given interval of time. Only page changes are listed here. If the same page is referenced again, it is not listed twice. So, these are the page different page referenced by the processor. These are the sequence of page number which are referenced in a regular interval of time. So, determine the four pages that are resident in main memory after each page reference. So, how will you determine which pages are available in the main memory after these pages are referenced. So, let us run this algorithm and try to understand how pages are replaced or referenced in this particular case using FIFO, first in first out. So, here in this case you can understand there are 4 pages can reside at a time, because 4K word is a memory space capacity. Only 4 pages can reside in this memory area. So, obviously, only 4 entries will be there in the queue, first in first out stack. So, whenever pages are referenced corresponding to that page, the identification number is entered here. So, this is the output. You can see this queue has input here and output from here. So, the counter output will be produced from this location. So, this is first in the sequence number which is having longest time period entry, that is given as 0. And next is 1, and then next is 2, and next is 3. These are the counter values or index values of this queue. So, you can see initially this queue is empty and the page number 4 is referenced by the processor. So, the 4 number page is not available, obviously there will be a page fault. So, this 4 will be entered here. This 4 number page is entered here, and corresponding to that counter value or identification number is given here or stored here in this FIFO stack. So, you can see there are 4 pages you can store in main memory. So, 4 pages can be transferred one by one. All the 4 pages which are referenced by the processor are transferred. Initially it is empty. So, obviously, 4 page fault will occur, because these are different pages 4, 2, 0, 1. So, these 4 pages first stored, and 4 corresponding to these 4 pages, 4 page fault occurs. So, these pages are stored here 4, 2, 0, 1. First 4 pages are stored, and now the queue or stack is full. No next page can be entered in this stack. So, we have to replace with some page number if next page is referenced. So, for example, next page which is referenced as 2, you can see the 2 number page is referenced. So, 2 page number is already available here. So, there is page available corresponding to 2, we can write here page is available. Next page is 6, which is referenced by the processor, because 6 number page is not available. So, page fault occur. We have to replace. Now, OS operating system will replace some page number which are already available in the main memory. So, in this FIFO algorithm, 4 number page is having longest time cycle or counter value. So, that is why 4 number page will be replaced. So, this page will be removed from this location. So, here you can see this output, and the 6 number page will be entered from here. So, page number which are available now after this replacement 2016. Now, the next page is 1. You can see the 1 number page is available. So, we write page is available. Next is 4 number page which is referenced, though because this 4 number page is not available, page fault occurs. So, this will be replaced with 2 number page. This will be removed because two number page is having longest time period in the main memory, or its identification number is at the top location of the stack. So, that is why 2 number page will be replaced, or it will be removed. Next is 0. You can see 0 is available, the page is available. Next, page number which is referenced as 1, it is available. So, we write page available 0, then we say page is available. Now, next page number which is referenced by the processor is 2, which is not available, page fault occurs, this 0 will be dropped and 2 will be entered from this location. And next is 3, next is 5 and 7, corresponding to these pages, page faults occur. And finally, you can see there are 4 pages which are having number 2, 3, 5, 7 will be remaining in the main memory. So, finally, these pages will be available with main memory 2, 3, 5 and 7. So, we can calculate how many number of page fault occurs. So, if you count these page faults, you will get number of page faults, that is 10 in this FIFO algorithm. Let us talk about next algorithm, that is least recently used, the simple algorithm. In this algorithm, what we do, what we have to perform, the first step is the counters is associated with every page that is in main memory. And in next step, when a page is referenced, its associated counter is set to 0. Whenever particular page is referenced, immediately its counter value is reset or set as 0. And in third step, at fixed interval of time, the counters are incremented by 1. So, regularly we increment the counter value of each page, and in next step, the least recently used, it is very important. The least recently used page in this case having highest count, that will be replaced only. The counters are often called aging register, as their count indicates their age, that is how long ago their associated pages have been referenced. And in next step, the page which has to be replaced can be easily be determined by current value of the counter. The page which is least recently used or the counter value is high, the page will be replaced. So, there are some advantage and disadvantage of this algorithm as well. So, advantage is the least recently used page is a better candidate for removal than the least recently loaded, which is the FIFO algorithm. And the disadvantage of this algorithm is it is more difficult to implement. In comparison to FIFO, it is difficult to implement. So, let us talk about the same example in this particular case. Initially, this queue is empty and 4 pages can store in this memory, or in memory space only 4 pages can store. So, 4 entries we will first introduce, or 4 pages can be transferred in this memory space. So, 4 page fault will occur in first case, or in first time 4 page fault occurs because these are different pages. Now, next is 2. 2 is available, we write simply page is available. So, whenever page is referenced, it is set to 0. Immediately, its counter value will set to 0. So, when 4 number page was entered, its counter value was 0, and when 2 number page was entered, the 4 number page having counter value 1, and the 2 number page will be having 0 counter value. and when 0 is entered, the four number page will be having 2, and 2 number will be having 1 counter value, and 0 will be having 0. And when page number 1 is referenced, this counter value will be given as 0, and this 0 number will be having 1 counter value, and this will be having 2, and this is 3. Oh, sorry, this is 4 in this case. So, each page number having their own counter values, and they will be incremented by 1 after some interval of time. And whenever particular page is referenced, the counter value of corresponding that page will be reset to 0 or set to 0. Okay. So, 6 page number is referenced, it is not available. So, page fault occurs. So, 6 will be replaced with highest counter value. The 4 number page is having highest counter value. So, it will be removed and 6 number page will be entered from here. Now, next is 1. 1 is available in the main memory. It is set to 0. This counter value, this page will be having counter value 0 because it is set to 0. It is referenced now. So, that is why this page number 1 will come here. Next is 4 number page, which is not available, page fault occurs. So, you can see this this 0 number page is replaced or removed because 0 number page is having maximum counter value. So, next is 0 page number is referenced because 0 is not available, page fault is occurred, and in that case the page number 2 will be removed because 2 number page is having maximum counter value. Okay, this way we can implement the LRU. Or next is 1 number page is referenced. So, 1 number page is already available, page available we write, page available, and it is set to 0, its counter value is set to 0. So, that is why 1 will be replaced here. So, this way we can implement the LRU concept, and finally, we can see the same page number as we have done in case of FIFO, 2, 3, 5, 7 pages are available finally in the main memory. And we can also calculate the page fault in this case also, here it comes 11. Now, the next concept is memory management hardware. As we have already discussed that virtual memory concept is a combination of hardware and software management. So, in this particular concept, we try to store those programs which are logically related in the virtual memory, and these program and corresponding data will be called as they are segmented. The virtual memory is segmented into different segments or divided into different segments. So, this particular concept will provide dynamic allocation of memory, and multiple users can access this virtual memory area or address space, and also the multiple programs can be stored in this virtual memory area or in auxiliary memory. And these information, these programs and corresponding to their data, they can be protected. The information protection can also be implemented or can be provided by this concept. So, in this case, the program or the data which are logically related, they are called as segment. So, this virtual memory or this address space can be converted into various segments of different size which are logically related. Now, virtual address space is converted into a number of logically related segments of variable size. Each segment will have different size. So, in this case, the minimum size of particular segment will be equal to one page, and maximum will be equal to the whole address space. So, it handles the mapping between logical address to physical address. So, in this case, we use the address used in this case in this memory management hardware is called a logical addresses, or these are logical address space, you can see, because the data which is stored which are logically related in this case. That is why the address used in this case is logical address space. So, we have to map the logical address with the physical address. in this concept. So, mapping is required. So, mapping between logical address to physical address is required in this particular case. So, you can see given logical address is having three parts. First is segment number, the second is page number, and third is word number. The logical address is divided into three parts, because program and corresponding to their data is stored, which are logically related to each other in a different segment. So, obviously, extra table is required in this case, which can convert the segment number to particular page value or page number. So, one more table has been introduced here in this case, which is used to provide the page offset value or base value, through which we can get the exact page number. So, you can see here the logical address is having three parts: segment number, page number, and word number, which are shown here: segment number, page number, and word number. And from the segment, this segment table, the first table will give the page offset value, which is added with the page number, corresponding page number, which is added here. The output of this segment table will be added with the page value, which is given in logical address. So, here addition operation will be performed. This will give you the offset or base value of page table. This base value will give you the exact page number, and from this page table we get the block value or block number, and that block number will be appended or concatenated with the word number or line number to get the exact physical address. So, this way we perform the segmented page mapping scheme. Similar to the previous case, memory page table, it has few drawback: the slow memory access, because 3 time access is required to map from segment to page, and from page to block, and from block to particular reference of page. So, 3 access of memory is required in this case, that is why it is slower. This is slower scheme. So, more number of empty spaces are there, as we have already discussed in previous case, number of presence bits which are empty, presence bit 0 which are empty. So, let us take one example in this case. To avoid this drawback, we can use one more concept, or fast associative memory concept. It is also called as translation look aside buffer, TLB. It is called as TLB. So, we can store the segment, corresponding page number, and block number in a single row of this table. So, this table will provide the segment number, page number, and corresponding to that page number, the block number directly. So, here we can get the information, segment number as well as page number and block number, in a single entry. So, let us take one example here. In this case, consider 20 bit logical address having 16 segments, that means 2 to the power 4, 4 bits are required for to map the segment, and there are 256 pages. So, 8 bits are required for mapping of pages, and in each page 256 words we can store. So, 8 bits are required to map or to address the words. So, this 488 is the entry of logical address: segment, page, and word. Now, consider a physical memory of size 2 to the power 20. So, physical memory is divided into two parts, that is block number and word number. So, how many blocks are there if page size and block size is same? So, there will be 2 to the power 12 blocks available in the main memory. So, 12 bits will be given to block, and 8 bits will be given to corresponding those block, 8 bits will be given to word. Let us try to understand this example. Suppose we have given a 6 number page, a 6 number segment, and page number 02, and this word line is 70. What is the physical address in this case? So, we have to first see what is the entry corresponding to 6 number segment. So, we have to access the segment page table or segment table first. Here this segment table will provide the page base value. So here you can see the entry of corresponding to 6 number segment is 35. This 35 will be produced by the table segment table. And here you can see this 02 is the page address which is added with the page base value. So 35 plus 2 operation will be performed here. So this is 37. This will come as 37. So this will come as 37. Now at 37 page number, we have now we have to access the page table. So you can see at 37 page number, the entry of block is 019, which is concatenated with the word line or line number. So 019 is produced by the page table, and corresponding to this 7E will be concatenated with the block number. So this is the final address of block, particular word of the physical memory. So you can see 0197 is the 7E is the address of particular referenced word number. So this word will be transferred to the processor if it is requested. You can see also here this architecture can store 5 pages. So you can see the 6 number segment, the 6 number segment can store only 5 pages at a time. This can also be implemented in TLB or translation locus-side buffer or associative or fast memory mapping scheme. So here 5 segment numbers corresponding to their pages and block numbers are stored in a single table. So this is the fast scheme to provide the particular word in a particular reference of the processor. So this way we can understand the management of hardware system or segment page mapping. We can understand of which is used for dynamic programming, and multiple programs can be stored here. In this case, the segment size may have different length or different capacity. So the size or the length of each segment may vary, it depends. So this way we can implement the segment page mapping. Thank you.